In August of 2022, the Secretary of State for Culture, Media and Sport agreed to add the Edgehill Engine Station in Liverpool to the national list of scheduled monuments. The Trust had first applied for listing status back in 2015, and then again in 2017. But it wasn't until Historic England updated their criteria for selecting sites connected to the early railways that our third COVID-hit and badly drawn-out application was successful. Before we take a look at the cutting and what was so special about it, let us first examine what it means to have the site scheduled. Listing and scheduling are two very different things. You list a building because it's of interest, be it through age, specific features, building techniques, or even because of who designed or built it. Once listed, the owner of the property is required to get planning permission before making any structural changes to it. Scheduling, on the other hand, generally relates to archaeological sites. They are usually of such unique value, even if there's nothing visible on the surface, that the government protects them from all and any activity outside of maintaining their current condition. This gives the owners of such sites a legal duty to maintain the site and to prevent any deterioration from happening. It also requires a scheduled monument consent request to be submitted to the Secretary of State before the site is disturbed in any way. The cutting becomes only the fifth scheduled monument within Liverpool, the other four being the Mott and Bailey West Derby Castle site, the moat surrounding Speke Hall, the Calder Stones, and the individual satellite stone known as the Robin Hood Stone. The Edgehill cutting is by far the youngest of the five and the most complex. Over the years, the Edgehill Engine Station has gone by many names. The Grand Area, the Brickfield Station, the Cavendish cutting, the Chatsworth cutting, and in the British Rail days, Wapping Head. It was a very cleverly organised multifunctional structure, born out of necessity due to laws and route concessions. When it was conceived in 1826, locomotives were banned from entering Liverpool, and this land was just over the border in what was in those days called West Derby. The actual civilised passenger terminal is a further 250 yards inside Liverpool, which is connected to the engine station via a small single-track tunnel. So imagine a passenger train arriving from Manchester. It arrives within the cutting, has the locomotive detached from the front, and then the train of coaches is pulled through the small tunnel coming out at the actual terminus at Crown Street. So far, so good. However, the railway also needs to be able to move goods and move them down to the Liverpool docks. This would be achieved by means of the Wapping Tunnel, the first tunnel in the world to be excavated from under a built-up area, and it was also the longest railway tunnel when built, at 2,250 yards, or 2,030 metres in new money. The tunnel also had a gradient of 1 in 48, which means that goods traffic coming up from the docks had to be rope-worked, and it is the evidence of this system that was the primary reason for the cutting receiving monument status. To expand, there are three main types of rope-workings. Drum-worked had an engine connected to a drum of rope that winds in and out like a fishing rod reel. Then we have the counterweight system that uses a weight or another train or trucks on the other side of the pulley, vastly reducing the strain on the engine as one train goes up, the other one comes down. The third and most complicated is the endless rope system, which is what was used at the Edgehill station. A rope 6 inches in diameter and twice the length of the tunnel has its ends joined together into a giant loop. This loop is fed round a single pulley at the lower end of the tunnel, and at the top it feeds through a series of tensioning pulleys. This pulley arrangement was powered by not one but two steam engines working with redundancy, then each engine also having the redundancy of having two boilers. The engines were housed either side of the line in 40-foot tall towers, which, thanks to John Foster Jr., the town planner, were embellished to include a Moorish arch to serve as a connecting bridge, but also as a grand statement of intent. Sadly, in 1865, the arch and the towers were demolished, and the cutting was widened by 7 feet along the south side. This was to allow for more tracks. It has largely remained in this condition ever since, save for numerous modifications to the track layout. The Wapping Tunnel and the goods depot at the docks closed in 1965, and the remaining coal and goods work in Crown Street ended in 1972, bringing to an end 142 years of continuous use of the engine station. After a decade of inactivity, when the cutting was cleared to expose the remains of the winding system, which in turn was briefly opened to the public during the 1980 celebration of the 150th anniversary of the opening of the railway, track returned to the cutting and the site has been used as a hedge shunt to this day. The Edgehill Engine Station is not just a site of local or national importance, it is globally important. It is not hyperbole to state that at this place, on the 15th of September in 1830, the world changed. Yes, it ushered in the first modern railway in the world, with separate directional tracks, with timetable and ticketed passenger services between two cities. But it also changed where we lived and worked and what we ate and how we told the time. But probably more importantly, it brought an end to the feudal system and created holidays for working class people. We will finish with Network Rail's video discussing what is to come next following monument status.
Hi, I'm Anthony Dawson. I'm a historian and an archaeologist, and I'm a member of the Liverpool and Manchester Railway Trust. I'm here in the Edgehill Cutting in Liverpool, which has just recently received scheduled ancient monument status as part of its historical value to England. This site is ground zero where the modern railway was born. It was from here on the 15th of September 1830 that the world's first passenger train of the modern mainline era departed. So this site has been scheduled and it's on the par with Stonehenge. And if you're interested in railways and transportation history, this is our Stonehenge.
I'm standing at the entrance to Crown Street Tunnel, just a few hundred yards away from Edgehill Station on the outskirts of Liverpool. I'm here with some of the operations team from Liverpool and some journalists who are here looking at the story of how this has been part of the railway history of our region for the last almost 200 years. I'm here looking at how it's been recognised recently as having a monument status, and also looking at what the future holds for a place that hasn't seen many trains in a good long time.
Hi, I'm Alan Gibbs-Manahan, Infrastructure Maintenance Delivery Manager for Liverpool Delivery Unit. I'm here at Wapping Cutting. It's a great opportunity to come to the site today after last week's announcement of monument status. It gives us a real opportunity to work with our community groups now to clear the site and to bring it back to what might have been its former glory.